This is Euclid, Book 11, Definition Number, I believe it's 25 here. Yep, it is. Now, Euclid, Book 11, Definition Number 25 is going to be probably one of the hardest ones for you to draw. And the reason why is because you have to draw three squares that are exactly the same size. Yeah, this is going to get fun. Now, you say, well, we can do this. Not a problem. All right. So what we're going to do is we're going to take this way down here, and we're not going to use the compass this time, okay? Now, we're going to draw the square. I'm going to draw it right across here. We're going to draw it 5 inches by 5 inches. Now, you say, well, that's pretty easy. Yeah, it is. First part is really relatively easy. Looks kind of messy, but really it actually is kind of easy to draw the first square. It's when you have to draw the remaining two that you get into the problem. Okay. Now then. Let's see. How are we going to do this? Oh, Ted, you can't let us down. I'm not going to let you down. I just need to take a look at something real quick. Hang on. It's going to be fun. Okay. Remember, each side of this square is going to be exactly 5 inches long. I think this is going to be about as perfect as we're going to get tonight. There's your cube. Yeah. Now, what is the definition of a cube according to Euclid? Well, it says, a cube is a solid figure contained by 6 equal squares. So, this is a solid figure. This side that we first drew, the top, this side, and the bottom, and the back end right over here, all 6 of those sides are 5 inches by 5 inches squared. And that is a cube by Euclid standards. All right. So now you know Euclid Book 11, Definition Number 25. Is it going to get more complicated? You betcha it is. All right, I will tell you more in a future video, so I want you to stay tuned.